بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أما بعد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Welcome to this series wherein we are going to be looking at 40 Hadith Nawawi, which is the 40 Ahaadeeth of Imam Annawawee. When we say Ahaadeeth, we are talking about the sayings, the deeds, the actions, the qualities, the approvals and disapprovals of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. And Ahaadeeth is plural of Hadith. So one is Hadith, and many, they are known as Ahaadeeth. So Arba'ina in Arabic means 40, and An-Nawawi refers to Imam An-Nawawi. So Arba'ina Hadith An-Nawawi means the 40 Ahaadeeth compiled by Imam An-Nawawi. So this kitab is a comprehensive collection of 40 authentic Ahaadeeth of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, or the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, compiled by Imam An-Nawawi. Imam An-Nawawi, rahimahullah, may Allah have mercy on him, mentions with regard to his Arba'in that the main point of consideration in the compilation of these encompassing, all-encompassing and all-embracing Ahaadeeth is that they convey some important principle of deen, known as usul deen, upon which the pivot of Islam rotates. And if one observes carefully, there are actually 42 Ahaadeeth gathered in total in this compilation. Many other muhaddithin, or the scholars of Hadith, were compilers of their own Arba'in as well. The first being by the great alim and jurist, Faqih Abdullah ibn Mubarak. May Allah have mercy on him. Other Arba'in kitabs include well-known authors, namely Darakutni, Hakim, Mustadrak. They composed Arba'in of some specific fundamentals of deen pertaining to specific topics, example 40 Ahaadeeth on Salah, 40 Ahaadeeth relating to Zuhud, Ascetism, 40 Ahaadeeth on Adab, that is Islamic etiquette, and many other topics. In every Islamic period, scholars have compiled innumerable Arba'in. However, till today, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has granted this renowned book of Imam An-Nawawi special acceptance. It is accepted by many scholars and many institutes throughout the world. And why specifically 40 Ahaadeeth? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in a hadith that man hafidhu ala ummati 40 hadithan min amri diniha ba'athahu Allahu yawm al-qiyamati fi zumarati al-fuqaha'i wal-ulama. That whosoever memorizes and preserves for my ummah, or my people, 40 Ahaadeeth concerning matters of its religion, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will resurrect him on the day of judgment in the company of jurists and religious scholars. Imam An-Nawawi rahimahullah began with attributing this specific hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, outlining the noteworthy virtues of a person who memorizes and preserves 40 Ahaadeeth as one of his reasons for his compilation of the Arba'in. The hadith mentioning the merits of preserving the 40 Ahaadeeth has been narrated by many illustrious Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum, such as Ali ibn Abi Talib, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, Mu'adh ibn Jabal, Abu Darda, ibn Umar, ibn Abbas, Anas ibn Malik, Abu Huraira, and Abu Sa'id al-Khudri. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with all of them. There are other narrations besides the one that I have just quoted that mention other virtues of memorizing and preserving 40 ahadith. And they state that Ba'athahu Allahu yawm al-qiyamati fi faqihan aliman, that whosoever preserves or memorizes the 40 ahadith on the day of judgment, Allah will resurrect that person as a jurist and a religious scholar. And another hadith says that on the day of judgment, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam will be an intercessor or a witness for him. Shafi'an aw shahidan yawm al-qiyamah, kuntu lahu shafi'an aw shahidan yawm al-qiyamah. That on the day of judgment, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam will be an intercessor or interceder for that person on the day of judgment. And another hadith also states that he will be written in the company of religious scholars and he will be resurrected with a group of martyrs. So these are some of the virtues that are associated with the preservation and memorization of 40 ahadith. And I do hope that inshallah all of us will be motivated to memorize at least 40 of the sayings of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, or 40 ahadith of the Prophet Muhammad, may Allah's peace and blessings be upon him. Until we meet again in the next episode, wherein we are going to continue our journey as we look at the 40 ahadith as compiled by Imam An-Nawawi in his kitab Arba'ina Hadith An-Nawawi. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among those who listen to the words and follow the best of them. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.